Hi, and welcome to this week's episode of the 2-Minute Guru. My name is Daniel Bogdanoff, and today we're going to talk about two key ways to measure jitter. You have period jitter measurements and cycle-to-cycle jitter measurements. Essentially, jitter is just how far away your signal's actual edge is away from the ideal edge that you have in a perfect world. For example, if I look at this signal as I zoom out, you can see the edges farther away from my trigger point get thicker and thicker. That's because there's some jitter on those edges. Let's take a look at how to measure it. Like I said, there's two different ways we're gonna look at jitter. There's cycle-to-cycle jitter, where we only care about adjacent cycles and we compare those adjacent cycles. And then there's timing jitter, where we look at an overall period of time and see how severe my jitter is overall. Before we actually make a measurement, I wanna talk about the difference between a peak-to-peak measurement and a RMS measurement. Peak-to-peak measurements, you have to limit how many cycles you capture and be consistent with that, because random jitter is gonna make those peak-to-peak values grow and grow the longer you capture it. Whereas an RMS measurement is gonna stabilize over time to a consistent value. So timing jitter is often measured with a time interval error measurement. I'm gonna hit measure, and we're gonna add a clock time interval error measurement, TIE. And the reason we wanna add a clock measurement is because our signal is a clock signal, it's repetitive. You can also look at jitter for data signals, you just have to recover that ideal clock period from the data signal. You can see I've now added the measurement, and essentially time interval error, or TIE, is just that classic jitter measurement, how far away is my edge from my ideal signal. Let's turn on some statistics. So the peak-to-peak time interval error values I'm seeing are about plus or minus 37 nanoseconds. If I were to measure this for a longer time, that value is gonna get bigger and bigger. Now let's look at cycle-to-cycle jitter measurements. The JEDEC65B spec says you should count at least 1,000 cycles or more. That's because random jitter has less of an impact here, so you're essentially just trying to get to a stable RMS value. So you can see that my standard deviation of this cycle-to-cycle measurement is about 870 picoseconds, and standard deviation and RMS value are essentially synonymous if your signal has an average value of zero, which we do here. Understanding the difference between period jitter and cycle-to-cycle jitter is helpful, but if you're debugging a circuit, you want to go deeper. So next week's video, we're going to look at jitter histograms and jitter measurement trends. So how can we actually acquire some insight into our system based on these measurements? If you like geeking out on jitter like I do, check out the blog post below. I wrote an article that covers these topics in more detail. Thanks for watching this week's video. If it was helpful, hit the share button below and subscribe to the Keysight Oscilloscopes YouTube channel. I really appreciate you watching, and I will see you next week when we get to talk a little more about jitter.